Hey friends, it's Mike, the Hi-Fi Insider. Today I want to show you guys a brand new product from a company called Borison. I discovered them recently at the Seattle Pacific Northwest Audio Show. I made a video about that show and I'll put a link in the description for you guys. When I heard their M6 line of speakers, which was $550,000 a pair. The price is extravagant, but I think that the performance matches its price. I think that if I had the money, I'd definitely get those speakers. It was that good. But also at the show, they had a more affordable speaker, the X series. It was the X3 for $11,000 a pair. And I was blown away by that model as well. So today I want to show you guys their brand new product, the X2, which is a step below the X3 that I heard at the audio show. It's a little bit less money. It retails for $8,800 for the pair. It's actually quite affordable. So let me show you guys what they look like. As you can see here, the lacquer finish. It's very nice shine. It's got carbon fiber on the top. You can also get this in a white finish as well. The tweeters are planar ribbon tweeters made by Borison, so they make all of their drivers. This cover is magnetic and it comes off so you can service the drivers. This is a 4-inch mid-range bass driver and then a 4-inch bass driver. It's a very nice finish. There are upgraded feet available if you want to do that. I haven't got a chance to install them yet before shooting this video. So on the back, these are their vents. They're not ports. Now I don't know the technical side of these vent system, but I can tell you that I can put them very close against the wall and not have a significant impact on the bass. Right now I have about a foot away from the wall. They are a little bit slanted. The speaker terminals are just two posts, positive and negative. I'm currently using JPS Lab superconductor speaker wires. They're incredible speaker wires. I recently upgraded to these from my MIT cables and these blow them out of the water, but they're not cheap. So when I had the X2 in the house, I literally had it unboxed and playing music in less than 30 minutes. It was that easy to set up and quickly dialed in.
My voice should appear to come from a single point at the far left of your soundstage. My location should be exact and well focused.
My voice should appear to come from a single point in the center of your soundstage. My location should be exact and clearly focused. No part of my voice should appear to come from the left or the right channel.
My voice should appear to come from a single point at the far right of your soundstage. My location should be exact and well focused.
I had him place in the same position as my Focal speakers. And I also have on loan the Denmark Audio Group's Axis brand of products, the Forte 1 integrated amplifier DAC streamer. This little box is incredible. It's very easy to use, very good performance. I'll make a separate video on the Forte 1. My room, I'm not sure if you can hear this in this video, it's not treated at all. I have window on one side and it's completely open on the opposite side. I just had new flooring installed, so there's no carpeting. It's a very echoey room. The bass on the X2 blew my mind. It completely blew my Focal speakers out of the water. For in terms of bass response, the quantity of the bass, and the quality of the bass. It's also very smooth sounding as well. It didn't have any treble peaks in any way, and which is very surprising because of the room that it's in. Listening to them on the XS Forte 1 was incredible, but I wanted to see how they sound off of the equipment that I was using with my Focal, the Sony integrated amplifier. Even though the Sony is modestly priced, it is a great performer. So listening to the X2 through my Sony integrated amplifier, it was quite amazing. I was shocked at how full, how detailed, and how smooth everything sounded compared to my Focal speakers. The Focal speakers in this room sounded very thin, and unfortunately that's why I didn't use it very much, because it didn't sound like the speakers that I bought. Because when I first bought these speakers, I actually had a dedicated music room. My wife really liked the design of these speakers because they are very low profile and they fit nicely in the aesthetics of our room. She does not like the look of my Focal speakers, and I get it. You know, they're a little bit dated. They're big also. The impedance of these speakers are 4 ohms. And they're rated at 87 dB, which is not super efficient, but to my surprise, my Sony amplifier can drive it to its full performance potential with plenty of headroom. The Sony amplifier is only 80 watts of power, and I'm sure if I were to throw my Macintosh at it, these play in my room much louder than I will ever listen at. And if you want something that give you a party, these speakers will do it. So I hope you guys can check out Borison speakers, and especially the X series. And I think that they're going to be at some of the audio shows, like the Toronto audio show coming up. And if you do check them out, let me know your thoughts in the comments. So thanks for watching, and I'll see everyone in my next video. Bye-bye.